Well, Slick Robbie D and Randy Orton tearing the house down at the Louisville Gardens, but right now it's time for a special type of match. UFC rules, submission or surrender. It's Ron H2O Waterman, a three-time UFC competitor and a black belt in jiu-jitsu, taking on former OVW champion Iron Man Rob Conway, and the rules for this match, as I stated. Submission or surrender. It's a tap out or a submission only. UFC rules, no holds barred. Let's go to Christmas Chaos at the Gardens for UFC rules action. Iron Man Rob Conway on his way to the ring. Conway, of course, an OVW mainstay, former several-time OVW heavyweight champion. Conway's physique is tremendous, and his athleticism and his craft is perfect. However, he has that obnoxious attitude, that narcissistic streak that we have taken to task many times. Conway is the most egotistical human being that will step foot in this ring tonight, and that's saying something, folks. And tonight, he will face an entirely different type of individual.
With, check this out, Ultimate Fighting Championship rules. There are no holds barred in this match. To win, your opponent must submit or tap out. Introducing first, 226 pounds out of Pittsburgh, PA, the Iron Man, Rob Conway!
Well, Conway looks like he's got something to say before this match gets started. Conway's always got something to say.
The Iron Man rules with our fists. But tonight, I'm going to be a compassionate man because I know that my opponent has an injured left elbow because I'm the man against. So I'm going to give him the chance now just to stay in the back, nurse his elbow, and let everybody know that he's a coward. Or he can be a stupid and knock down that aisle, face the Iron Man, and have him take that arm off and hit the hell out of him.
Well, Conway, with some very outrageous statements to make about Ron H2O Waterman. Of course, just about 10 days ago, Conway was scheduled to face H2O, who he said was a greenhorn and a rookie and shouldn't be taking up the Iron Man's time on television. Well, Conway, in that match, jumped H2O on his way to the ring, ran his left arm into a concrete pillar and then trapped it and hit it with a steel chair. H2O refused to back out of this match tonight, and H2O will be coming to the ring with his left elbow heavily taped. He has been undergoing therapy on it for the past 10 days, trying to get as good as he can be for tonight's event. But Conway will still have the advantage that H2O, a three-time UFC competitor, a black belt in jiu-jitsu, has been an amateur wrestler and a wrestling coach for over 13 years. He is handicapped tonight by an injury when he faces the Iron Man.
Colorado, ladies and gentlemen, he is a three-time Ultimate Fighting Championship competitor. Put your hands together for Ron H2O Waterman!
Tremendous ovation for Ron Waterman, who has come to the Gardens ring tonight at Christmas Chaos with his game face on.
Man either submits or taps out. Referee Nick Dubon.
Dean Hill reminding the folks here that this is UFC rules, no holds barred. Eye gouges and groin strikes are barred. Everything else is legal. And the only way to win this match, there are no pinfalls. There are no disqualifications. It must be a submission or a tap out. Submission or tap out will tell the tale here between Iron Man Rob Conway and Ron H2O Waterman. Waterman, a tremendous physical specimen, and he's got the weight advantage on Conway. Conway coming in at 226, and his body fat percentage has to be down below 5%. But Waterman, a rock hard 270 pounds. What an interesting dichotomy in terms of personality of these two men as well. In addition to their different athletic backgrounds, the different ways that they train to become professional wrestlers. They are also two differing individuals. Conway, as we said, not only narcissistic and conceited, but egotistical. He never met a mirror he didn't like. Whereas Waterman is a Christian. He's an artist. He sells artwork in two different Colorado art galleries. He's been a school teacher and a wrestling coach for most of his adult life. So Ron Waterman, a very different personality than Rob Conway. But bear in mind, wait a minute, Waterman pulls Conway backwards. They went right through the ropes. They fell right to the concrete floor, and Conway, already limping, could have twisted or broken his ankle in that fall. Waterman taking it to Conway, battering the Iron Man around the ring. Referee Nick Dumeyer trying to get them back in the ring, but Waterman is chasing Conway, and Conway trying to get some space, some separation in between them. Conway back in the ring now, still disoriented, fires an elbow back. Remember, folks, Conway, the more experienced man, he's a four-year veteran, trained at the OVW Training Center under Danny Davis. He and Nick Dinsmore, two of the premier graduates of the OVW Training Center, and he is a veteran and a thinking man's wrestler. H2O has competed in many forms of mixed martial arts and hand-to-hand combat, but he's a rookie as a professional wrestler. Conway ducked under the clothesline, sends the boot to the stomach, now twisting up the injured arm, and right there, as we said, Conway, a thinking man's wrestler. He's a smart wrestler. He is a very cunning wrestler, and he's going already this early in the match to the injured body part of Ron H2O Waterman. Wait a minute, what to shoot Waterman off? Waterman reversed it, brought Conway to the knee, gut-wrench suplex. Conway being treated like a small child by this powerhouse who has stunned the folks in the Ultimate Fighting Championships on several occasions, including one match, his debut in the UFC, which was a victory by tap out for Ron Waterman in barely 45 seconds. Waterman. Now he's got Conway hooked up, brings him back into the middle of the ring where Conway cannot get to the ropes to try to force a break. H2O trying to turn Conway over into a Boston Crab, and he does it. The pressure on the lower back. Now written across Conway's face, you can tell the tail there by the pain. Etched across the Iron Man's face, he's trying to reach the ropes. But H2O has that Boston Crab cinched in tight. Conway has made the ropes. Conway always knows where he is in the ring. That's what makes him such a smart wrestler. Positioning means so much. Conway knows where he is at every opportunity. Wait a minute now. Waterman back outside trying to chase Conway again. Conway thrown into the ring again by H2O. Conway hits those ropes. H2O down trying to trip Conway. Conway goes over. Conway with a boot right to the chest. And there's a knife-edge chop to the sternum. And again, Conway sends H2O across, goes for the clothesline. H2O ducks, has his man trapped. Inverted atomic drop there, right down on the groin, and a clothesline. H2O really putting the pressure on Conway. Belly to back suplex. H2O more powerful, stronger. But as we said, Conway, who has already showed a couple of veteran-like tricks in this match, Conway is so much more experienced. H2O sends Conway across, charges in and catches the boot. Conway, in the nick of time, managed to raise that boot. And I'll tell you what, the ill will amongst these two men, as we said, started on television when Conway accused Ron Waterman of being a greenhorn and a rookie and of taking up his television time. Ron Waterman's not going to let any man talk to him in that manner. And Waterman challenged Conway. But Conway, so treacherous, jumped H2O from behind on his way to the ring, injuring that arm that he is now continuing to work on and apply the pressure on. And as everyone knows, especially anyone who's competed in the martial arts, a joint injury to the elbow or the knee or the ankle or the shoulder is the most painful and disabilitating injury that an athlete can sustain. Even worse in many cases than a broken bone. So Waterman has really showed a lot of guts just coming into this match tonight, much less what he has gone through over the past couple of minutes with Conway. Look at Conway cranking that elbow, turning it the way other than which nature intended it, wrapping it around his head. Now the arm barred and the ligaments that we already suspect may be damaged as a result of the prior attack. Those ligaments are being stretched now to nearly the breaking point by Iron Man Rob Conway, who continues to mount the offensive and to put the pressure on Ron Waterman, who has shown so many guts in just fighting. And now Waterman, wait a minute, Waterman firing back with right hands. Waterman firing back, sends Conway across, catches him with the elbow. Ron Waterman trying not to use that left arm, but force of habit. Waterman with the elbow drop. Waterman, a lot of steam has been taken out of his blows as a result of the punishment he's undergone, but he's still managing to manhandle the Iron Man. Conway up and over in the backdrop. Conway, once again, as he's done twice before in this match, rolling to the floor to seek respite from H2O Waterman. Hey, what? H2O charge. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, no. Waterman went for the clothesline. Conway ducked out of the way in just the twinkling of an eye. And Waterman clotheslined that steel ring post with his bad arm. A big mistake here. This could be a turning point mistake. Conway, now like a shark in bloody water, hooks up the arm. Conway with the leverage, standing over Waterman. Waterman shaking his head. No, he won't give it up. But Waterman clotheslined that steel ring post with that injured arm. Hit it. No telling how much more damage has been done to the injured elbow of Ron H2O Waterman, who is still shaking his head. No, he will not give up. But Conway, the look of desperation on his face as Conway continues to mount the pressure. Waterman no longer moving here. And look at the look on Conway's face. He's giving it everything he's got. His former bodybuilding champion cranking up on the, and there, Nick Dumeyer stopping the match. Nick Dumeyer is stopping it. Ron H2O Waterman appears to have lost consciousness, and Conway will not let go of the arm. Waterman has lost this match. He did not surrender, folks. He did not tap out. He did not submit, but he has lost consciousness. And referee Nick Dumeyer, now there's Robert Briscoe and Ray Ramsey trying to get Conway off of Waterman. There's Joe Wheeler. Referee Nick Dumeyer has stopped this match for the good of Ron H2O Waterman's health and his career. He passed out there from the pain. He did not submit. But nevertheless, Rob Conway has won this UFC rules match here tonight at Christmas Chaos.